It's the oldest established permanent floating crap game in New York. Yes, it's the oldest established permanent floating crap game in New York. Yeah, yeah, la, la, la.
Thank you.
This is the way our concert ended, on stage at the Fox Theater in Detroit, Michigan. The evening was part of a tour that would take us from coast to coast in the United States, plus concerts in Japan, Australia, and 12 countries in Europe, appearing in front of over maybe 1 million people. You know, I've always enjoyed performing, but this tour was really special. It all began, strangely enough, in a quiet little press conference in the Crystal Room of the Beverly Hills Hotel in California.
Why don't you get in real quick?
It's going to do something. I think I'm really excited about what the three of us do individually as well. Because it's reconstructed now, Jeff. Really.
Will the three of you all sing together at the end?
A whole lot.
It's fun because we can share
and that joy.
You know, it would be different. I wouldn't
want
to do it alone, but I certainly love
doing it with Frank and Sam. And if you got to travel, you might as well travel with a leader. You got to do that kind of tour, and I ain't getting on that bus. What song were you all three singing together?
You name it, we're singing.
We got a medley that ends all medley. I swear to you, Frank opened up the music the first day and went from like from here to where he's standing with the microphone.
Frank and I have worked together a number of times, and I've worked with Liza a number of times. It's the first time as a professional that we've ever put anything together where we started from scratch and went for it. And that's exciting. We've been rehearsing for the last week or so, and the rehearsals have been just tremendous.
Down here,
Mr.
White.
Okay, thank you.
The press conference was over about, I guess, 11 in the morning.
Some chauffeur that guy's got, huh?
And as you know, Sammy likes to stay busy, and since rehearsal didn't start until 2 o'clock, on the way, Sammy stopped and did a benefit. He cooked a meal for three people, recorded an album, made two movies, and he was there early. The energy this kid's got exhausts me.
You can even eat the dishes.
By the time I got there, Sammy had the band going full out. Man, he loves to rehearse. And I'm just the opposite.
Could you hold it down? I'm rehearsing.
What are you talking about?
Stranger here.
What is this? What is this, all dressed up?
I have clothes at the house.
It's a preview.
This guy gets mad because I dress up. I've never seen him.
We gotta go, guys.
We gotta go. Please.
Yes, that's stop running. More strings.
I gotta get ready before she comes. Got to make certain that she...
Now, there's a real interesting story about how this tour came together. While I finish rehearsing, Sammy will tell you about it.
We're sitting in Chicago, and we started talking about people because we were looking at the fall edition of the tour. Who would be ideal to come in? And names started coming from people suggesting. And Elliot said, you know who would be the greatest? And I looked at Elliot. Elliot looked at Frank. Frank looked at me. And I said, but her schedule is busier than mine. Frank said, nah, she's probably too busy. And we'd never mentioned the word yet. Never mentioned the magic word. And suddenly, I said, but man, with her between us, Frank. And we're sitting like on a one-to-one here. Elliot's over there. We're sitting on a one-to-one. I said, but with her between us, would that be something? Would that be an event? And Frank said, no, Sam. It would be the ultimate event.
I've been doing this a long time now, and it's the most fun I think I've ever had. You go into a strange town, into an arena that seats 17,000 people, and for 3 hours, you just have a great time. The audience enjoys the show, but I don't think any audience ever had more fun than Sammy, Liza, and yours truly, Old Blue Eyes.
Thank you so much, you're marvelous.
And sing a song, 100 people have to get on a plane.
You know?
Only because there's so much involved. I mean, it's not just 100 people who do nothing. Every single person has a very definite job and does something important.
Oh, I don't know how many she has. I don't know actual count.
There's about 15 of us. You know, which, but that's 12, that's also 12 musicians.
I have 13 that travel with me.
There's a lighting guy, there's a lot of sound technicians and
stage manager, musicians.
And there's crew people.
Road manager.
My assistant, who needs to come in, and just the various people.
I know she has a dresser, a hairdresser, blah, blah, makeup, blah, 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 blah. Frank has one guy. He's trimmed the fat.
I don't think there's enough people in this room to tell you. There's not enough people in this room.
Well, wait till the rest arrive.
Wait till everybody else has arrived, because this is only the beginning. Don't you want to know what we're going to do after the show itself tonight?
What are you going to do after
I'm not going to take all these people to dinner. That's what I'm not going to do.
They just had a big lunch here.
These people eat a lot. These people.
Well, why don't we turn this back? Yeah. Why don't you pin it
from here to...
Yeah.
Make sure it covers here.
Yeah. Okay. And then let's do this side.
It's really important to me to feel comfortable on the stage because I've got too much going on in my head to worry about not being able to turn a certain way or not being able to do a certain thing, to be restricted. Halston says I look best when I'm comfortable, when I look like I'm comfortable.
Liza always has the best ideas, and then we just make them work.
He makes you feel... like you look really comfortable and really nice and you don't have to work at it. Then you can just be who you are. I must say, looking into Sinatra's eyes up on stage is something. Those are the bluest eyes you have ever seen. It's just incredible. And he really looks at you too.
Yeah.
I mean, you know you're being looked at when Sinatra looks at you. And Sammy's concentration and his energy is so vast now and so pinpointed. He's better than he ever was. I honestly think that. I'm up there and I think, my God, I'm standing next to Frank Sinatra. He's singing in my face, my nerves, you know. And then I look in there, Sammy, I want to die. I mean, it's just my dream come true. And if I feel that way, then I guess people in the audience must feel that too. Also, it's 60 years of music you're looking at. You know, 60 years. It's very exciting.
The thing that kills me is when I see young people react to us. You know, the kids who like Prince, Bruce, Michael, you know, who are their fans, they'll come and see us, sometimes out of protest, you know, and... Then they'll walk away going, oh, they'll come backstage or we'll see them in a restaurant and they'll say, wow, we really enjoyed you. I mean, no, I mean, we really enjoyed you, you know. That's nice. And Frank and I, and Liza and I, will look at each other and go, you know.
It's always fun.
Yeah?
It's exciting because both of them have a lot of energy and it's a different kind of energy, too, and it's really quite marvelous. And I couldn't think of working with anybody else and having as much fun as we had.
Liza just keeps getting better and better and better and better. She's stronger now than she's ever been, off stage and on. But on stage, she's just a joy. Frank and I look at her, and then we look at each other, look at her. Because I've done television with her. I've done theaters, nightclubs with her. And it was always a joy to work with her. But now it's can't wait to get to the theater.
There's a great feeling when Liza and I get to the theater first, usually about 2 hours before showtime. Frank comes in about 40 minutes before the show starts, which gives him an hour 45 minutes before he goes on the stage. Well, we get in early and we run back and forth in each other's dressing rooms, checking on each like we haven't seen each other since we left the hotel. But it's that's part of it, the camaraderie, the fun, the total respect as friends that we have for each other, and the professionalism. Always the professionalism.
And I said, you know, show business is my life. And the guy said, why? And I had no answer.
Something funny happens all the time. I think in about 2 hours, a lot of funny things are going to be happening.
The funniest reaction I had was when girl came up to me and said, gee, this isn't old fashioned at all. I would say, no. She said, this kind of, it's really about, you know, like the words and everything and the love songs and all those character songs and this. And she loved it. She just loved it. Usually we all sleep in because you got to rest your voice for a certain amount of hours or you sound funny. And then we call each other and say, what are you doing? I don't know, what are you doing? What's on TV? What's the name of this actress in this movie? I'm always calling Sammy and asking him that. Then we'll meet and we'll have something to eat, maybe. And then we go to sound check.
When I think of the times gone by, and I think of the way
Adelaide.
I cry, I could honestly die.
Adelaide.
You gamble it here, you gamble it there, you gamble it
everything. For Christ's sake, Adelaide. And you never did
it. Working with Sammy and Liza, quite an experience. The energy they generate just amazes me. They are, in one word, marvelous, and I love them dearly, both of them.
Over the years, we have survived not only as performers, but we have survived as friends. And the friendships have deepened over the years, along with the respect that we have for each other in terms of the growth that we've all made, personally, professionally, all of that. So that there's a lack of one-upsmanship when we're on stage together. Nobody's trying to, well, wait till he hears this, or wait till she does this or that, or why is she doing this, or why is he doing that. Nobody ever says that. But there's a great deal of love and a sense of each other that I think that gives us something kind of special.
You might give me the brush. You might forget to stay. And so the best that I can do is pray.
You're also responsible for each other up there, because it's a very long piece of music we have to do together. We have to do two quite hefty medleys. And every once in a while, if we've been traveling or if somebody's tired, somebody will forget to come in. So you have to remember and kind of help each other out. Plus, there is no choreography. Nobody has staged this. Because Uncle Frank thought we really didn't need it. So nothing is ever the same. Sammy and I go every place where Frank isn't. That's our staging. We stand where Frank doesn't. That's basically it.
Stick with me, baby. I'm the guy that you came in with. Luck be a lady.
We're you're very lucky. Everybody can work separately, and that's terrific. But to have the opportunity to work together. I mean, I'd rather be in Detroit with Sammy and Frank than alone. You know what I mean?
Hello, Detroit. You won my heart. Your renaissance and waterfront give you a flair of your own. Irresistible you. Hug and kiss of you. You're alive with so much feeling, and I will always be there for you. And I will say a little prayer for you, for I will always care for you. Detroit, a big D, Motor City, and the Motown sound that's got the whole world singing. I will always be there.
Get your program.
Irresistible you, hug and kissable you. You are alive with so much feeling, and I will always be there for you. And I will say,
I spend a lot of time in this place in the old days.
Oh, yes.
For you, for I will. And the Motown sound that's got the whole world singing. I will always be there for you, and I will say a little prayer for you, and I will always care for you. Hello, hello, Detroit. Hello, Detroit. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you very, very much, ladies and gentlemen. Thank you for the warm reception on behalf of my compatriots, Miss Minnelli and Mr. Sinatra. It is a joy to be back in the theater that means so much to all of us, and to see it done so beautifully. And to be back in the city is beautiful for me. Thank you. With a song in my heart, I behold your adorable face. Just a song at the start, but it soon is a hymn to your grace. When the music swells, I'm touching your hand. It tells me you're standing near, and at the sound of your voice, heaven opens its portals to me. Can I help but rejoice that a love such as ours came to be? But I always knew I would live my life through with a song in my heart for you. With a song in my heart, I behold your adorable. just a song at the start, but it soon is a hymn to your grace. When the music swells, I'm touching your hand. It tells me you're standing near, and at the sound of your voice, heaven opens its portals to me. Can I help but rejoice that a love such as ours came to be? But I always knew I would live my life through with a song in my heart for you. With a song in my heart for you.
Change.
Thank you.
Who can take a sunrise, sprinkle it with dew?
Thank you.
Cover it with chocolate or a miracle or two. The Candyman, yeah, Candyman can. You know the Candyman can, 'cause he mixes it with love to make the world taste good. And who can take a rainbow, wrap it in a sigh, soak it in the sun to make a groovy lemon pie? The Candyman, Candyman can. You know the Candyman can, 'cause he mixes it with love to make the world taste good. The Candyman makes everything he makes satisfying and delicious. Talk about your childhood wishes. You can even eat the dishes. Who can take tomorrow, put it in a dream, separate the sorrow, then collect up all the cream? The Candyman, Candyman can. You know the Candyman can, 'cause he mixes it with love to make the world taste good.
That song was written by Leslie Bricus and Anthony Newley, and it was given to me as a gift 14 years ago. It's the best thing that ever happened to me on records, nationally and internationally. But about 10 years prior to the gift that they gave me of Candyman, they had laid another one on me that was pretty good too.
What kind of fool am I, who never fell in love? It seems that I'm the only one that I have been thinking of. What kind of man is this that refused to see what could be seen by everybody else but me? What kind of lips are these that lie with every kiss, that whispered empty words of love that's left me alone like this? Why can't I fall in love like any other man? And maybe then I'll kind of clown am I? What do I know of life? Why can't I cast away?
Thank you. Thank you very, very much.
For me, on a personal basis, I thank those of you, as I look in the audience, I know there are some people out there who have hung in with me through the years, and I thank you for that. I really mean it from my heart. I would also like to apologize to the younger members of the audience that I don't do anything from the top 40. No, I'm not putting down the music or the performers. It's just that I am 62 years old, and I feel like a damn fool standing up here talking about, if you think I'm sexy, come and touch my body, you know. No, I'm not going to do that. No way, Jose, baby. But, you know, it's so funny. People know about my relationship with Frank, with Dean, with Liza, of course, and the people of my people, my age group, more or less. And they don't know that I have friends among the younger performers, the younger stars in this business. Guys like, Rick James is a friend of mine. Prince is a friend. Huey Lewis, you know. Michael Jackson is more than a friend. He's like a son. He really is, because I've known him ever since he was 6 years old, and I've watched the growth in the man and how he's grown as a performer. He is fantastic. I don't think he scratched the surface of where he's going to wind up in this business. It's frightening to see him on stage. And the metamorphosis that takes effect. Because if he's at the house or something, oh, Mr. D, I was wondering, could I borrow some tapes? I would like to go. If you could, I'll give you some of my, you know, then you go to the concert, man, and it's something else, you know. And it's kind of frightening, but me do one of his numbers, there ain't enough money in this entire city. You understand me? Me to get up here and think I can do Michael Jackson? Ha, 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 ha! I'll tell you one thing Michael's done. He's the only man that I've ever heard of. I've been in show business almost 60 years, ladies and gentlemen. He's the only man I've ever heard of that gets on the stage in front of 75,000 people singing a song and go, oh, I've never seen that before. And I'm no prude, mind, you know, no prude. And I'm a sports fan. I'm used to seeing guys go, you want to throw the ball over here, Harry? Just to be singing a song, man, and go, oh, you know. No wonder he can hit all them high notes. Guess I've been doing it wrong all these years. Allow me the privilege of doing one more for you before I leave here. Thank you. This is a little out of the ordinary, because it's from a show that I've fallen in love with. The show I speak of is Phantom of the Opera. The story of the Phantom is very theatrical, and it dares to be theatrical. Because it's about a horribly disfigured man, a musician, who lives in the sewers of Paris. His particular labyrinth is beneath the Paris Opera House. The year is 1865. He has it so rigged that he, the Phantom, can hear everything that goes on in the Opera House. One day he hears a girl singing. Her name is Christine Daae. He falls in love with her voice. He falls even more madly in love with the girl. So much so that he kidnaps her from the Opera House and brings her down to the sewer. She is frightened beyond words, and he tries to explain his love for her. Meet the Phantom. I am your angel of music. Come to me, angel of music. Nighttime sharpens, heightens each sensation. Darkness stirs and wakes imagination. Silently the senses abandon their defenses. Slowly, gently, night unfurls its splendor. Grasp it, sense it, tremulous and tender. Turn your face away from the gaddish light of day. Turn your thoughts away from cold, unfeeling light, and listen to my music of the night. Close your eyes and surrender to your darkest dreams. Purge your thoughts of the life you knew before. Close your eyes, let your spirit start to soar, and you'll live as you've never lived before. Softly, deftly, music I'll caress you. Hear it, feel it, secretly possess you. Open up your mind, let your fantasies unwind in this darkness that you know you cannot fight. The darkness of my muse. Music of the night. Let your mind start a journey through a strange new world. Leave all thoughts of the world you knew before. Let your soul take you where to be. Only then can you belong to me. Floating, falling, sweet intoxication. Touch me, trust me, savor each sensation. Let the dream begin. Let your darker side, give in to the power of the music that I write, the power of my music of the night. Thank you for allowing me to stretch. May I share that with this wonderful orchestra, ladies and gentlemen, under the direction of Mr. Morty Stevens. One, two, one, two, three, four. One singular sensation, and you can't forget the rest. For that girl is second best to none. Why, she's fun. I said, ooh, my, I give her your attention. Do you, I really have to mention, she's the... Ladies and gentlemen, she's simply the best. Liza!
Come on, babe, why don't we paint the town? And all that jazz, I'm gonna bruise my knees and roll my stockings down. And all that jazz, start the car, I know a whoopee spot where the gin is cold but the piano's hot. It's just a noisy hall where there's a nightly brawl and all of that jazz. Slick your hair and wear your buckle shoes. Father Dip is gonna blow the blues. And all that jazz, start the car, I know a whoopee spot where the gin is cold but the piano's hot. It's just a noisy hall where there's a nightly brawl and all of that jazz. Oh, you're gonna see your sheepers in this shape. Where I store the juice and all that jazz. Come on, hon, we're gonna brush the sky. I bet you lucky Lindy never flew so high. Cause in the stratosphere I put him in that ear to do that jazz. No, I'm no one's wife, but oh,
Would you like to hear a new song? Thank you. I found a song that I'm just crazy about. It's about a girl who lives in a seaside town. You know, it could be Amsterdam, it could be Marseille, it can be anywhere you want it to be. But this is her story. Ladies and gentlemen, by Charles Aznavour, Sailor Boys. My early years were years of joy. My parents taught me love and pride. But then I met a handsome boy who took my childhood in his stride. A golden youth, a careless whim, who once upon a summer's day persuaded me to lie with him and stole my innocence away. Sailor boys, I wait beside the harbor gate. I'm here in sunshine and snow. For lonely boys and eager boys, for boys with nowhere to go. I raise my arms to greet you home, to give you shelter from the wild winds of the sea. In attic bedrooms high above, the world of ordinary men, the golden boy and I made love, for love was all that mattered then. There in the hollows of his bed, he took my passion and my pride, and swore by heaven overhead that he would love me till he died. Sailor boys, I wait beside the harbor gate. I'm here in sunshine and snow. For lonely boys and eager boys, for boys with nowhere to go. I raise my arms to greet you home, to give you shelter from the wild winds of the sea. Disappeared without a trace. Perhaps he ran away to sea. I should have known he couldn't face the child that grew inside of me. And now I soothe with lullabies the golden girl he'll never know. She has his bold and reckless eyes, but only mine will see her grow. Sailor boys, I wait beside the harbor gate. I'm here in sunshine and snow. For lonely boys and eager boys, for boys with nowhere to go. I raise my arms to greet you home, to give you shelter from the wild winds of the sea.
Listen. Well, I'm not even going to say how long ago. A couple of years ago, I heard this absolutely terrific, absolutely true story, right? So I told this absolutely terrific, absolutely true story to a couple of friends of mine who happened to be called Candor and Ebb. They're wonderful songwriters, right? And guess what happened, right? Absolutely true, absolutely terrific song. Wait a minute. I have so much hairspray in my hair, I cannot get these glasses.
Gather around, I've got a story to tell about a Manhattan lady that I know very well. She lives at 5 Riverside, her name is Shirley DeVore, and she traveled around the world to meet the guy next door. But there was trouble inside apartment 29E, 'cause Shirley's mother and dad were as upset as can be. They said, "We hate to complain, dear, and we don't like to grouse, but you're nearly 32, you should get out of the house. You gotta ring them bells, you gotta ring them bells, you gotta make them sing and really ring them bells. It's such a happy thing to hear them ting-a-ling. You gotta ring them bells." Well, Shirley was 31, but she was loath to admit, and she had never been loved, which didn't thrill her a bit. And so she sat and she thought for hours on end, and said, "I'll go to Chase Manhattan, where I got me a friend." And so she borrowed a vow and called TWA and told her mother and dad that she was up and away. "I'm gonna travel the continent a month, maybe two, and haul me home a huzz if it's the last thing I do." You gotta ring them bells, you gotta ring them bells, you gotta make them sing and really ring them bells. It's such a happy thing to hear them ting-a-ling. You gotta ring them bells. She met a Londoner first, but they did not hit it off, 'cause every time she approached, he got a bronchial cough. And so she went to Madrid and met a handsome señor, but he liked to throw the bull and he was no matador. She also bombed down Brussels, in Mallorca and Rome, till someone said, "Try Dubrovnik, dear, before you go home, 'cause it's the kind of a town where you'll be likely to fall, and all the Tony cognoscenti find the Balkans a ball." Darling, if you haven't, you should. I mean, you must. I mean, you've got to ring them bells. You've got to ring them bells. You've got to make them sing and really ring them bells. It's such a happy thing to hear them ting-a-ling. She went to Dubrovnik, and the very first day she met a guy on the beach who took her reason away. Yes, it was love at first sight and quite a beautiful scene. She said, "My name is Cheryl DeVore." He said, "I'm Norm Saperstein." She said, "Are you from New York?" He said, "Well, that can't be denied. Yeah, I've got a swell junior 3 at number 5 at Riverside." "What? No, wait a minute, did you, excuse me, I didn't hear you. Did you just say you live 5 Riverside Drive, New York City? That's where you live? Because that's where I live. I live at 5, you live at 5, no, do you, I said, you live, I live, are you sure?" As if that wasn't enough, we surely thought she'd gone deaf when he told her his apartment there was 29F. Yes. She was E, he was F, and they had not even met until she traveled the world to Yugoslavia yet. He we've always been right next door, and she would never have known if she hadn't tried to bluff me. She might still be alone. Well, there's a moral to learn from little Shirley Dimmore, who had to borrow a thou to find a lover next door. You girls who live in apartments, don't just stare at the wall. Open up the door and hurry out in the hall. And ladies and gentlemen of the orchestra. Also, there's one man in particular who I'd really like you to meet. I've known him since I was 11 years old. He's the finest musician I know. And he's my friend. Ladies and gentlemen, Mr. Bill Lavornia. You know, one of the things that all singers try and do is they try and find a new kind of love song, you know? And I think I found an interesting one. I guess you could call it a foreign language song, if in fact loving somebody is trying to communicate to them and to tell them that, then this is a story about two people who speak a different language. My lover makes no sound. His language is his hands. I watch his fingers dance and try to understand. I try to understand his elegant ballet. In my heart I can hear the words he longs to say. And so I've learned to speak a language he can hear, to tell him how I feel whenever he is near. He lives around the block. It's just a little walk. We'll meet tonight at 8. At 8 tonight, we'll talk. Oh, my love. Oh, my love. Quiet love. I am calm whenever you are near, and somehow I can hear what your heart longs to say. I have a small surprise to spring on you tonight. I'm learning how to sign. Please God, I get it right. It's something that you do with confidence and ease. I'm clumsier than you. This might come out Chinese. No, wait. But come and feel my heart. It's never danced this way. I'm nervous, and it's hard. I have so much to say. I've always been afraid. My dreams seem so unreal. But But now I bless this world for how you make me feel. Oh, my love. Oh, my love. You are shy, so am I. But if you will tell me that it's true, you feel the way I do, then tomorrow can start as we are. Together we'll grow old, for wise men always say that in silence there's
sitting alone in your room, can't hear music play. Life is a cabaret, old chum, come to the cabaret. Put down the knitting, the book and the broom, it's time for a holiday. Oh, life is a cabaret, old chum, come to the cabaret. Come taste the wine, come hear the band, come blow that horn, start celebrating. Right this way, your table's waiting, rooms permitting some prophet of doom to wipe every smile away. Life is a cabaret, oh chum, come to the
to have this girlfriend known as Elsie, with whom I shared four sordid rooms in Chelsea. She wasn't what you'd call a blushing flower. As a matter of fact, she rented by the hour. The day she died, the neighbors came to snicker. Well, that's what comes from too much pills and liquor. But when I saw laid out like a queen, she was the happiest corpse I'd ever seen. I think of Elsie to this very day. I remember how she turned to me and said, what good is sitting all alone in your room? Come, hear the music play. Oh, life is a cabaret, old chum, come to the cabaret. And as for me, ha! And as for me, I made my mind up.
It seems we stood and we talked like this once before. We looked at each other in the same way then. I can't remember where or when. The clothes you're wearing are the clothes that you wore. The smile you're smiling, you were smiling then. I can't remember where or when. Some things that happen for the first time, they seem to be happening once again. And so it seems we have met once before, and then we laugh. Before, also loved once before, but who knows? Who knows where or when? What power! We lose. Some things that happen for the first time, they seem to be happening once again. Seems we have met once before, and then we laughed a lot to before, also loved a lot to before, but who knows?
Thank you so much. I don't know about you, but I'm dizzy. Woo! Okay. This is a song by Orlando Burden, Ronald Miller. Oh, who the hell are you out there? Best songwriter.
For once in my life, I got someone who needs me, someone I've needed for so long. For once unafraid, I can go where life leads me. Somehow I know I'm gonna be strong. For once I can touch what my heart used to dream of long before I knew. Someone warm like you could make my dreams come true. Once in my life, I won't let sorrow hurt me, not like it hurt me once before. Once I've got someone I know won't desert me, and I'm not alone anymore. For once I can say, that's mine, you're not gonna take it. Long as there's love, babe, you bet I'm gonna make it. For once in my life,
someone who needs me. Gonna take it. Long as there's love, babe, you bet I'm gonna make it. For once in my life, I got someone. Yes, for once in my life, I found someone. Once in my life, I got someone who
thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Practice, practice, practice. Hey, the shark has pretty teeth, dear, and it shows them pearly white. Just the jackknife has my key, dear, but he keeps it way out of sight. When that shark bites with his teeth, dear, scarlet billows, they begin to spread. Fancy white gloves, though, has my key, dear, so there's never, never one trace of red. On a sidewalk, one Sunday morning, lies a body oozing light. Someone sneaking round the corner. Could that someone perhaps, perchance, be Mac tonight? From a tugboat on a river going slow, a cement bag, it is dropping down. The cement is just for the weight, dear. Do you suppose that our boy, he did something wrong? My man Louis Miller, he split the seam, babe, after drawing out all the bread from his stash. Now Mac Heath spends just like a pimp, babe. Do you suppose that our boy, he did something rash? Old Satchmo, Louis Armstrong, Bobby Darin, they did this song nice, Lady Ella too. They all sang it with so much feeling. That old blue eyes, he ain't gonna add anything new. But with this great big band swinging behind me, rocking hard jack, I know I can't lose. When I tell you all about Mac the Knife, babe, it's an offer you can never refuse. We got Frank Jr., we got Bill Miller at the piano. We got the great Herb Cotter playing the drum. And his wonderful band bringing up the rear. All these bad cats in the band now, they make the greatest sounds you're ever gonna hear. Old Suki Tawdry, Jenny Diver, Polly Peachum,
Polly Peachum,
Miss Lulu Brown. Oh, the line forms on the right, dear. Now that Mac Heath, yeah, that bad man is Mac. I tell you what you better do now. You better lock your door and call the law, because Mac Heath, that
dirty son of a... He's coming back. Get under the bed. All right, go to the country anyplace. Otherwise, he's going to get you.
Thank you. Thank you very much.
You're very kind.
Thank you very much. In case you're wondering, it's not tea. We come now to the daddy of all saloon songs. Leave it that way, it's nice and dark. For this song. Harold Arlen, Johnny Mercer, Nelson Riddle. Song about a man whose chick has split. And he's hurting very badly. Ask Eddie Fisher. He cried a long time, boy. Oh. I'd lend him 12 handkerchiefs in those days. Anyway, this is kind of my, almost, I suppose, my favorite kind of song to sing, because I was a saloon singer as a boy, 17 or 18. In little bars around Jersey and New York, Connecticut, and places like that. And simply tells a story of, as I said, a guy who's left alone because his chick has taken a train or something. And he doesn't know quite to handle it. It's very tough. So after about 2 weeks of sitting in his house, or his room, I should say, he decides to take a walk and get among us, come out among us again. And he falls into a small bar. Nobody in there but the bartender and him. So would you assume the position of one single bartender? And he finds somebody to tell his story to. It's 2:45. There's no one in the place except you and me. So set 'em up, Joe. I got a little story I think you ought to know. We're drinking, my friend, to the end of a brief episode. Make it one for my baby and one more for the road. I know the routine, put another nickel in that machine. You see, I'm feeling kind of bad. I wish you'd make the music easy and sad. I could tell you a lot, but you got to be true to your code. Let's make it one for my baby and one more for the road. You'd never know it, but Buster, I'm a kind of poet, and I got a lot of things I wanna say. And if I'm gloomy, please listen to me till it's all
all talked away. Well, that's how it goes. And Joe, I know you're getting anxious to close. Thanks for the cheer. I hope you didn't mind my bending your ear. But this torch that I found, it's got to be drowned, or it soon might explode. So make it one for my baby, and one more for the road that long, that long, man, it's long.
A wonderful song. A great song. Thank you.
I'm just waiting for a downbeat, or not for a bus. Where are you working tomorrow? I can say that joke to him because he's my son. Frank Junior. Take a bow, Frank. This is a song that has done a great deal for my career. And it was brought to me by my little friend, Mr. Paul Anka. And now the end is near, and so I face the final curtain. My friend, I'll make it clear, I'll state my case, of which I am certain. I've lived a life that's full, traveled each and every highway, and more, much more, I did it. Regrets, I've had a few, but then again, too few to mention. I did what I had to do, I saw it through without exemption. I planned each charted course, each careful step along the byway, and more, much more, I did it my way. Yes, there were times I guess you knew that I bit off more than I could chew. But through it all, when there was doubt, I ate it up, then spit it out. I grew tall, faced it all, and did it my way. I've loved, laughed, and cried. I had my fill, my share of losing. And now as the tears subside, I find that it's all
so amusing to think I did all that. And may I say, not in a shy way, no, not me, I did it. What is a man? What has he got? If not himself, then he has not. Not to say the things he truly feels, and not the words of one who kneels. The record shows I took the blows, and did it. So much. Ah, come on now. Thank you so much. Thank you. You're very kind. Thank you. I should like now to introduce my cohorts. Come on out, gang.
May I say that, as the chairman of the board, you were cooking tonight. Yeah.
I don't want to be the chairman of the board, because they ain't nowhere to go after that.
No, man.
What are you doing in town?
We came to see you.
That's it. The hottest ticket in town, man.
We're going to do a little something here?
Yeah.
All right, surprise me.
Ha, ha, okay. Flag, time, offsides.
Look at Charlie jealous.
No, you guys will team up and do that. That ain't fair.
Well, all right, we don't have to do that. I mean, if we don't mention New York, you don't mention New York, I don't mention New York, Frank doesn't mention New York.
I don't know about that. I might want to mention New York.
Yeah, but we can't. I mean, we'll make a bargain, right? So what do you want to do?
I don't care, so long as we do something that's got style.
If that ain't a song cue, I never heard it.
You got it, it stands out a mile.
A flower's not a flower if it's wilted.
That's true.
And a hat's not a hat unless it's tilted.
You've either got or you haven't got class.
How it draws the applause of the masses
when you wear lapels like the swellest of swells. You can pass.
I taught Gene Kelly everything the bum knows.
And smile. You've either got or you haven't got. Got or you haven't got. Got or you haven't got.
S-T-Y-L-E. Those fingers in my head.
Style.
Breaking hit the stairs, lip strips my conscience bare. I'd switch a craft. And I've got no defense for it. The heat is too intense for it. What good would common sense for it do? Cause it's witchcraft.
It's such an ancient pitch, but one I wouldn't switch.
You rhyme that, we all go to jail.
Cause there's no nicer witch than you.
Listen, while we're talking,
what?
Liza with a Z, not Lisa with an S, cause Lisa with an S goes not Z, it's Z instead of S, lie instead of, look, as simple as can be, see, Liza, then M-I-double-N, then E-double-L-I, you double up the N, that's not new, then E-double-L,
what the hell is she talking about?
That's the way you say, Minnelli, Liza Minnelli. It's easy.
It's the sleazy.
It's easy.
No, no, it's easy. No.
What?
Easy, not sleazy.
It's
easy.
Sleazy.
Oh,
no.
Wow.
See? Liza.
There we go.
Hey. If I could talk to the animals, just imagine it, chat with the chimpanzee. If I could talk to the animals, walk with the animals, grunt, squeak, squawk with the animals, and they could squeak and squawk, they could, oh, squeak and talk to me. Just want to see if you're paying attention.
All or nothing at all.
This is before our time, Liza.
Before everybody's time. There is no in between. Why begin to cry for something that might have been? No, I'd rather have nothing at all.
What about money?
I got a few bucks. What do you have in mind?
Money, 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 money. When you have a dead cold in the stove, then you freeze in the winter, and you curse to the wind at your fate. When you haven't any shoes on your feet, your coat's thin as paper, and you look 30 pounds underweight. When you're gonna get a word of advice from the fat little bastard, he will tell you to love evermore. But when hunger comes to rat, rat-a-tap, rat-a-tap at the window, love flies out the door. Money makes the world go round.
Once in a lifetime, I feel like a giant. I soar like an eagle as though I had wings. For this is my moment, my destiny's called me. Though it may be once in a lifetime, I'm gonna do great things.
What the hell are you yelling about? They can hear you out there, Sam.
I keep forgetting I got the job.
I'm not too sure. I've got you under my skin. I've got you deep in the heart of me. So deep in my heart, you are a part. I have got you under my skin. I would sacrifice anything come what might for the sake of having you near. Spite of a warning voice comes in the night, it repeats how it yells in my ear.
Maybe this time I'll be lucky. Maybe this time he'll stay. Maybe this time, for the first time, love won't hurry away. Well, all the odds are in my favor. Something's bound to begin.
Whether I find a place in this world or never belong. I wanna be him, but I gotta be me. Daring to try to do it or die, I gotta be me.
When somebody needs you, it's no good unless she needs you. All the way through the good Orlean years and for all those in between years, come what may. Who knows where the road will lead us? Only a fool would dare say. If you let me love you, sure I'm gonna love you all the way, all the way.
Yeah, all right. All right. Ready to go to surrender.
Hey, old friends, what do you say? Old friends, are you okay? Old friends, are we unique?
Unique.
Time goes by, everything else keeps changing. You and I, we can continue next week.
Yourself, Frank.
I already did.
Here's to us.
Us.
Who's like us?
Nobody.
Please. Damn few. Sing your song, Sam.
Now from a whippoorwill high on a hill, we grabbed a new note.
Fight, fight, fight. She gets much too hungry.
All right.
For dinner at 8. She loves the theater, but she never jumps in here late. She'd never bother with a bum that she'd hate. That's why the lady is a tramp. Doesn't dig dice games with sharpies or frauds. Never goes up to Harlem, Lincoln's or Ford. She won't dish the dirt with the rest of those girls. That's why the lady, she's a tramp. She loves that wonderful, marvelous, that cuckoo wind in her hair. Life without a care. She's broke, what the hell. She hates California because it's cold and it's damp. That's why the lady, that is why the lady, that's why lady is a tramp.
Yeah. Sounds like the blues to me.
Sometimes you're happy and sometimes you're sad. For the world goes round, and sometimes you lose every nickel you've had. But the world goes round. Sometimes your dreams get busted in pieces, but that doesn't matter at all. Take it from me, there's still gonna be a summer, a winter, a spring, and a fall. And sometimes a friend starts treating you bad, but the
Liza. There's a boat that's leaving soon for New York. Stop that! Come with me. That's where we belong.
It all.
show.